India win their first ever T20I in New Zealand after winning the second match of the series by 7 wickets. Indian captain Rohit Sharma scored 50 and became the highest run getter in T20Is. Also, India bowled really well courtesy a good bowling performance by Krunal, Pandya and Khalil Ahmed. So today we'll be discussing about how these individual performances panned out during the game and how we get into the third T20I and looking into the series. So I have Ghosh with me today and Anirudh discussing about the game. So Ghosh, what do you think about Rohit Sharma's performance today? He got to his 50 after getting out for one run in previous match.
Yeah, it was a really good outing for him, considering the way that he faced like certain roadblocks in the previous match, both as a captain and a skipper. Considering the way he didn't get a start on a good batting pitch last match, he scored like just one or two runs, and then like he faced like almost 10 or 11 deliveries. So today from the ball one, he was like really aggressive, fluent, and the way he played those strokes effortlessly.
Yeah.
That was more remarkable about his batting. Like we all know that if he gets going, like he will be like one of the disruptive guys. Right. We can ever see out there.
We also saw that he became the second highest six hitters in T20Is, and also he has the India record now. He broke Dhoni's record. He has 349 international sixes.
Yeah, actually that's the whole beauty about his batting, that he will hit big strokes like so effortlessly.
Right.
There is like an element of like lazy elegance in his stroke playing, but at the same point of time, today also like. I think what actually helped him to score those vital 50 runs is that as a captain, he made those perfect moves at the right time to win the Indian. So, like if you are a captain and you are also like one of the key batsmen of your side, if you do like your one of the jobs like excellently, it actually helps you to do the other one. Equal is
right,
and he also became the third cricketer to hit 100 T20 sixes.
Right, yeah, after Martin Guptill and Chris Gayle. So, Anirudh, what do you think about Krunal Pandya's man of the match performance? He got the early wickets and he didn't let the New Zealand batsmen get going what they did in the previous game. So, because of which India could restrict them at 158 runs. So, what do you think?
I think Rohit did a good thing that he didn't drop Krunal Pandya, because in the previous match he performed really not good with the ball. And today he was up to the mark. He bowled really well. He was adjudged man of the match for his performance.
Right.
And
talking about dropping players, even Khalil Ahmed gave away a lot of runs in the previous game, but he came back strongly in this game and finished off the game really well. Like he got in four overs, he just gave away 27 runs and picked up two wickets in the last over. What do you have to say?
Actually, the similarity between both Khalil and Krunal Pandya is that like whenever they start a major series, like you will see like the first game they will always end up on the higher economical side, but then as the series goes on, they come to their elements and they actually like justify that why they have been selected. For example, like he was speaking about Krunal Pandya, like when India toured Australia some 2 months back in T20s, also in the first T20 he wasn't that good, but in the remaining two matches
he came back
brilliantly. He bowled as per his strengths, and he like didn't let the batsman to
dominate him
because being a spinner in T20 is like very difficult, very difficult job. And talking about Khalil, I think he's very much on the World Cup 2019 plans, so it's better like if the upcoming Australia series also he gets like more and more matches to play, because
initially he put in pressure on Siffert, who
like to say it was same teams, same set of players but different results.
Would you guys like to add what was different today than the previous game?
I would say the difference between the two sides today.
And the wickets early in the match also proved
I think the dot balls, initially four dot balls.
Obviously, because if you are playing against New Zealand in T20s at their backyard, what actually happens that, the average score, in case if they're batting first, will always be around like above 160,
170. Yeah, the average here was 172.
So you have to like bring a lot of variations on board, like slower balls,
right,
slower bouncers, yorkers. And I think what was different today in India's approach is still, like as you said, they built the pressure.
Right.
They didn't give like too many boundary scoring deliveries in the first 6 overs.
Yeah, talking about another young player, how do you see Rishabh Pant at number 3? He scored 40 runs, he finished off the game with Mahindra Singh.
Yeah, he hasn't played a lot of white ball cricket recently. And I think it was good that Rohit gave him chance and he played really well. And he is also in the lineup for World Cup, he's very much
2019 ODI squad. Yeah, so also there was in the game today there was one controversial incident where Daryl Mitchell was given LBW on field, but the replays after he took the DRS, the replays showed there was a clear inside edge. So what do you have to say about that?
Yeah, that has been like one of the drawbacks of DRS. It's like there are like certain things like which they can't like track. The fact is that, in this case, I don't actually blame the players. It was like more the third umpire like, who should have taken the call. Like, if you are like doubtful about one particular decision, go back. You have all the technologies with you. Check it again and again.
The decision was out. So I think the third umpire didn't have conclusive evidence to...
But there was a clear hotspot. But the clear hotspot is the evidence.
Yeah, on-field umpire Simon Dole called it ridiculous because there was a clear deflection as well as a hotspot showed a clear inside edge.
It's like more like ridiculous.
But on the sneakometer there was no.
The thing is that like it's ever since it was introduced in, if I'm not wrong, it was introduced in 2018. Ever since it has been introduced, the only drawback is from the technological point of view.
Right.
Like if, for example, today we saw like what sneakometer wasn't showing, hotspot showed that.
Right. Yeah, so the game was done and dusted.
And imagine it would have been a World Cup knockout game. It would have cost them dearly.
Right. It was a great game for India today. Let's hope India can win the third T20I and win the series in New Zealand and finish off a great tour of the Southern Hemisphere that includes Australia and New Zealand well. We'll be coming back for the next T20I. Keep watching TNIE videos.